Welcome to the step-by-step tutorial on how to load data using a flat file into Oracle Profitability and Cost Management Cloud. I'll be using data management. This tutorial is the first of a two-part series. With data management, you can load data and metadata into an application using a data file, from an application to a data file, between applications. In this tutorial, I'll be loading data into an Essbase application used to store data for my Oracle Profitability and Cost Management Cloud application. For a complete list of supported applications, visit cloud.oracle.com and locate the Oracle Financial Data Quality Management Enterprise Edition Administrator's Guide. Before we begin, you must have your data file ready. Here's a list of tasks I need to complete. Register my source system. Register my target application. Define an import format. Define a location. If your data file's metadata structure does not match the metadata structure of your target application, you must define mappings. Period mappings define the calendar mappings between your source and target systems. Category mappings define scenario mappings between your source and target systems. Data load mappings define the relationship between source members and target members per dimension. And define and run a data load rule. Part 1 covers the following sections. Part 2 covers the following sections. Let's begin. On the Setup tab of Data Management, I'll register my source system. A predefined entry for file source systems is delivered with Data Management. If unavailable, you can create one. Configure Source Connection is used to store the general ledger connection URL, username, and password. It's not required for this integration. Next, I'll register my target application. I'll be importing into an Essbase application. Application details differ for each application type. The Dimension Details tab lists the dimensions you can export to. Here are the dimension names. The target dimension class is determined by the dimension type. For Essbase applications, you must specify the appropriate dimension class for account, scenario, and period. The data table column name contains the name of the column in the data management staging table. For Essbase applications, you can select the dimensions to create a drill region defining the granularity for the drillable region. You can specify the order in which the maps are processed in the sequence column. Modify or verify these columns and save your changes. The target application name is listed using the Essbase application name and the database it will be exporting to. Next, I'll define an import format. Import formats determine which data columns are extracted from the source system and how they are stored in data management staging tables. The name identifies the import format when you assign it to other configurations such as location. Descriptions are optional. I'll be importing using the file source system using a delimited data file type. For target, I'm selecting the target application I registered. I'm selecting comma as a file delimiter. Drill URLs are not required for this integration. Verify and save your changes. The import format identifies the content structure of the source file or system. When you create an import format, you also define the import format mapping definition between the source and target dimensions. This is where you define the relationship between your source and target dimensions. You can enter mappings manually or use Import Format Builder. When the source system is a file-based data load, use the Import Format Builder feature to map source fields graphically to target dimension members instead of typing the starting position and field length. This feature is available for both fixed and delimited files. I'll upload my data file and start mapping. The data file is opened in Import Format Builder. My data file does not contain column names. To start mapping, highlight the first column of the first data record and click Assign Dimension. Enter the source dimension name, target dimension, and field number. The first column needs to be mapped to account. Next, I'll perform similar steps to map the rest of the columns. The second column needs to be mapped to entity. The third column needs to be mapped to amount. Review your selections and click OK. My mappings are displayed. You can choose to load data into specific members by adding their names in the expression text box. Next, I'll add a location. You define locations to specify where to load data in the target system. The location links the import format to the target system. Enter a name. Descriptions are optional. Then, select the import format you defined. The source and target systems are selected for you. This concludes part 1 of this tutorial. Click here to start viewing part 2. In this tutorial, you saw how to load a data file into Oracle Profitability and Cost Management Cloud using data management. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.